So again, in the 80s, it was crazy. I did go to the clubs a lot because I danced. So I was like a little go-go boy all over the place. Then I got a job at Studio 54 because I started...
You were a bus boy?
Yeah.
Really?
That and a part-time house photographer. That's how I got all these pictures of like Andy Warhol and all that stuff.
Oh my God.
Because I had the inside scoop. I was basically hired because I used to hang out front every night. Every night there's a fire hydrant that sits right there. And I would sit on that fire hydrant. That was my stump man. I'd be the first one to get there. And Mark, the doorman, he was one of my, what I call beefcake boys. I photographed him for a calendar. And him and I became real good friends. So he'd be on the headset the whole time from inside. And, you know, he was the theme of the night. I mean, he was told by Steve Rubell, basically, this is what I want to accomplish tonight. Make it happen. So he would go out there and, you know, some nights he would let everybody in, and other nights, you know, if you saw the movie is true to form. There were some nights there was only five people in the club and there was 300 people standing out in the street trying to get in, thinking there was no room. Well, then the next night there was 500 people because I went to Studio 54 last night and I couldn't get in. Yeah. Well, then everybody wanted in. Yeah. So his strategy and his marketing was incredible. Yeah. I mean, he really was. But again, it was the drugs and the whole scene, you know, of just not running your business right because you're so fucked up. You didn't, you know. And there was a disco Dottie. She didn't die in the club, though. They made that just to make it dramatic, but Dottie was incredible.
Did you see Bianca ride in on the horse?
Yes. It was her 30th birthday. Yeah, 30th birthday party. I actually, my section that night was Liza Minnelli and Halston. And of course, then Liz Taylor was there and Brezhnikov. And so there again, that experience taught me to respect people and their privacy also, because obviously the drugs were very fluent and very out there, you know, and so you'd see so-and-so doing this and doing that.
Downstairs.
Yeah.
Sometimes even upstairs, and sometimes mostly up on the sex balcony. I mean, when I'd have to go up there and get the drink glasses and stuff, I'd have to step over people giving blow jobs and stepping over lines of coke and, oh, what the hell? Oh, pardon me. You know, it's like, you never knew what. But I loved it up there.